with Tormach. Today we're going to talk about the Haimer 3D sensor. It'll measure in X and Y and also in Z. You can do your whole workpiece setup with one tool. Now, if you're going to be using the third axis, the Z axis, with this for your touch off, you've got to measure this like you measure your tools, and this offset has to be entered in your offset table. Okay, that's spelled out in the machine manual itself how to use these. Now, the first time you go to use this, you're going to want to check the concentricity of the tip, make sure that it's running true with your spindle. They're set at the factory, but you're going to want to check it before you use it just to ensure that it's the tip's running concentric. And if it's not, there's screws right here, and that's what we're going to adjust. There's a supplied Allen wrench, and that's how you're going to adjust the concentricity of the tip to the spindle. There's four set screws on it. Let's clamp it up. Let's see how it runs. So the indicator dial is moving about 2.5 thou as I rotate the Haimer in the spindle. So we'll adjust it with the set screws on the... Now, if you watch the indicator, it doesn't move at all. So we got the ball running nice and concentric with the spindle. After you've got that adjusted once, that's probably not going to move around on you much. As long as you don't, you should be pretty gentle with these anyways, being a precision instrument. As long as it's not getting bumped around, that shouldn't move on you. But it's probably good practice to check it once in a great while. This will show you true center of the spindle. There's a 4 millimeter ball on here. 2 revolutions on the dial will bring the axis of the machine to true center of the Haimer. And it reads 0 with the little red indicator and also the black one. Okay. We can find the XY corner here for 0. Okay, so I got it all lined up. Now we bring it in. 1 revolution. Now it's coming on the 2nd revolution. Right there. The Y of the machine is lined up perfectly with the part because we moved that tip off. So now we can just zero our Y here. Now the front of our part is our 0. And then we can do the same with the X. The X 0. Okay, so that's how you use it to find a corner. Okay, go to 0 on the X and on the Y, that's gonna either find you the edge you're looking for, or like we did both X and Y, to find the corner. You can also use it to find the center. Touch off on both Y the positive side and the minus side and split the difference to find your center of a workpiece. And that's I'll show you now. And when you're finding the center, it doesn't matter if you go the full two revolutions like we did for the side, or if you just do one revolution, okay? Just as long as you do the same on both sides. Like, I'll just do one revolution here. One full revolution, it's zero on the readout. I'll zero my DRO. And then on this side, the part, I'll just do one revolution. And then divide that overall number by two. And that's going to be my X center, okay? And then we can do the same in Y. Well, that's our X, Y, zero, picking off the outside. Now, we can do Z, bring it down. Just like that. The way to use this, the third axis function, the Z axis function with the Haimer, you have to have that number measured like you measure the rest of your tooling. And that number entered into your tool offset page, and then that tool number called up, so it's referencing it. You can't just zero the axes now and expect it to work. It's got to be done just like it's spelled out in the machine manual. So that's how you find the corner. That's how you find the center in X and Y. Now we can pick up a hole with this also. And we do it the same way as we found the outside of the part, zero off each side. But what we'll do is we'll do X twice, because you can see I'm shifted off the center of the hole, because you're never going to be right on the center of the hole. So just do the whatever axis you pick to do first, do it first, and then do it again after you find the other axis. Now you can divide that by two. Now I'll jog to the DRO read zero. And then I'll do the Y axis. And then after I have the Y, I'll go back and redo the X. So that's how you pick up a corner, pick up the center of a square workpiece, and to pick up a hole. They're very quick to use and very accurate. Like I said, the first time you use it, first time you take it out of the package, go ahead and dial the concentricity in, and it'll be really accurate for you. Good, accurate, quick way to pick up your workpiece.